everybody, it's Susan Michon here at the Techie Mentor. I just want to take a moment to say thank you for stopping by my YouTube channel, the Virtual Assistant Tips, Tricks, and Advice channel, where I share all things virtual assistant every week with zero fluff, just the stuff that gets results. This week's topic is all about balance. So what I'm really talking about here is, I guess, what you would call work-life balance, but really it should be called business-life balance. And I've been somebody who's struggled for years to attain, or obtain, I should say, work-life balance. And because once you start working in your house full-time, it can overtake your entire life because your office is in your house. There needs to be appropriate boundaries. Another thing for those of you who have come out of a job, one of the things that you have to put in place for yourself is the structure that a job provides. So, you know, what hours you work, when you take breaks. A lot of us don't do that because we are so excited to actually be out of the cube farm back at home full time that we forget to get out of our pajamas or take a shower. You know, I was guilty of that too, because it was so exciting not to have to commute to an office. Well, sooner or later that's gonna get old and you're really going to have to find a routine that works for you. So first off, you need some type of structure. And what I mean by that is structure plus boundaries, okay? So structure around, when do you get in the office? When do you start your day? When do you take breaks? When do you take lunch? When do you take time off? Do you work Monday through Friday? I think it's important to understand when you do your best work. Like, I'm not a morning person at all. I don't really start moving until after lunch. So I'm somebody that gains steam as the day goes by, but it took me a long time to figure that out, because I'd always had to be at work at like 7:30 in the morning, and I'm not a morning person. So part of becoming your own boss and working from home is self-discovery. Don't do what everybody else does, because this is not a cookie cutter business. It's not a job. You get to write your own structure, your own guidelines. So figure out what works best for you. And it may take trial and error. I know that's what happened to me, because I was so ingrained in being an employee that I thought I had to be at work by 8. No excuses. That didn't work for me, right? So find the times of day that works best for you. Now, if you're somebody who has a job, you have a little more of a challenge, especially if you're doing administrative type work, which means you have to be in front of your computer during certain times of the day. This is why I went with back-end services, because I didn't want to have that. Plus, I had a job when I started my business and I needed to do the types of tasks I could do whenever I had the time, as long as I met my deadlines, right? So you're still gonna need a routine if you're working a full-time or even a part-time job. When are you gonna work on your business? You need to figure out that that schedule. So as far as boundaries are concerned, make sure that you set boundaries, because it's very easy to wander into your office any time of the day and sit down. And I'm guilty of this, because weekends I really have to keep myself out of my office for any reason. Because if I go in here, I'll think of all the things I need to do and I'll sit down and then the day goes by. And that's not healthy for you either. And I'm sure your family would like to see you as well. You have to realize you have to take time for you, because you are the business. What is your self-care plan? So not only do you have to have a schedule for when you work and when you do your best work, you also have to create the structure around when you work and when you take time off. Do you work Monday through Friday? Remember, no cookie cutter here. You can do what you want to do. We get so absorbed in our own business and our clients' business, a lot of times we forget to take care of ourselves. If you get sick, you're the business. So self-care should be something that should be a priority. And I am the poster child for what not to do for self-care. I mean, it's taken me years to finally figure out that I need to put myself before everything else, because if I'm healthy, then I have a great business. If I'm not, then my business suffers, as well as my family. So a self-care plan would be something that's very important, whatever that looks like for you. And a morning routine is real important too. I know for the first couple of months, I believe I worked from home, I thought, this is great. I don't have to get out of my pajamas, right? I could just walk into my office. Now, obviously on days that I had client meetings, I did look presentable, but just the thrill of not having, again, to dress up and commute was huge for me. Well, that got old too. what I found works for me is I need to take it seriously. I need to think that I am going to an office, not a job, but an office where I need to be presentable. So I get up in the morning, right? I have my morning routine. I meditate. I do yoga. I take a shower, right? So I'm what they would say camera ready every morning, and I show up in my business dressed and ready to go. I didn't do that for a long time. And to be honest, my business suffered because of that. Once I changed and put myself first, which I know for a lot of us is hard when we have kids and family, but remember, your business is you. And so if you're unhealthy, then your business has a tendency to be unhealthy because you cannot be fully present and in your business. So self-care is very, very important. What does that look like for you? But you also have to have time off. For the first 3 years I think I had my VA business, I didn't take any time off except for holidays. I didn't go on a vacation. Again, not healthy. And believe me, I have been sicker than I've ever been in my life when I became my own boss because I worked myself into the ground. Again, reason to make sure that you have that self-care plan. But sometimes you just need days off where you can do mindless things. I mean, you know, I'll clean a closet sometimes just because I don't want to think about anything. So make sure you have in your schedule some time for you to pursue whatever your passions are. You know, if you like to hike or run or walk or crochet or whatever, make sure you have time and you embrace that and you leave your business behind even though it's in your house. If you have a door to your office, close it. Like, I usually leave my purse in my office, but I've learned if I do that, then I have to come in here on the weekends. And I'm like, oh, you know what? I really should just do this one thing. And then one thing becomes an hour. So I move my purse out of my office on Fridays. So that way I don't get it. You know, I don't go back in my office, hopefully, until Monday morning. So self-care is so, so important. Boundaries are so, so important. And, you know, I'm talking almost physical boundaries here to keep you out of your office. You know, especially if you have a room that is an office, not just at a kitchen table, it's a little easier because your family is around. Put boundaries to keep you out of your workspace. Now, if the only time you can work is on the weekends, that's different, okay? But if you're home full time, what you need to look at is how can you set boundaries so you're present for your children or your husband or whoever is home with you, even your furry friends, your pets. Make sure that you have a schedule that works for you, has a schedule that works for them, and that you're not totally self-absorbed in your business, because it's very, very easy to do if you're a workaholic like me. And I've had a rough road to get to where I am today. It's probably taken me 3 to 4 years to figure it out because I'm stubborn and I thought I needed to be, I think I always need to be busy, and that's not healthy. You need some downtime for you. So a little bit about my story, hopefully it's helped you, but I think the key things here are set some boundaries, some physical boundaries, so you're not going in your office on your off hours. Set the hours that work for you based on how you work. You know, if you're a night owl, great. If you're a morning person, great. Figure it out, and you may not know this until you get home full time, because right now you're probably going to a job where you have to be there at a certain time. And so you need to find out what those natural tendencies are for you. So have those boundaries, put that structure in place. When do you go in your office? Remember, it's your business, your choice. It was so hard for me to tell clients that I didn't start my day until 9 a.m. I was terrified that I was gonna get in trouble, because I'm like, yeah, okay. You teach your clients how to work with you. So start with what works best for you. Figure out what your dream day looks like. Your days start here. I only worked Monday through Thursday, and then Friday, I didn't do client work or client calls. I worked in my business. Now, I only work in, you know, do client calls and stuff now Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays. I don't do it on Mondays or Fridays. It was so hard for me to say, okay, I can't be available then, because I was afraid of being reprimanded or fired from all the years of being an employee. So realize that you can do this, but it's a mindset thing that you have to work through to get to the other side of that. So baby steps, start where you are today and make a decision. If you need to get up and you need to get dressed to go to work, then do that. Have a morning routine that helps you get into the right space for you to be present and do the best work that you can for yourself and your clients. So hopefully this has given you some ideas. I'd love to hear your comments, your questions, if you had any ahas as well. But I think for me, it's an ongoing battle to achieve what I would call balance in my life. But it's a quest, and I'm on this journey, and I will make sure that I figure it out as I go along. And thank you for your time, and please feel free to subscribe so you don't miss anything, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.